going to work on a print and cut. The first thing you want to do is click on upload and locate your saved file on your desktop. I have saved a butterfly image on a white background. And so I'm going to upload that into Design Space, and it's a very simple image, so I'm going to click on simple. I click on the background to delete it. And then make sure that the one that I'm saving is the print and cut image, not just the cut image. So the one on the left is the one that I want outlined in green. I'm going to load that into Design Space. Adjust the size. My printer can handle 8.5 by 11 paper, so I don't want to go too large. And then I'm just going to double check here that it is set to print. And then I will click on Make. The next step would be to choose my printer and have the paper print out on the printer of choice, or the printer that you have. And then once this is done, you will take that print, put it on a mat, and then go to the next step using your Cricut. So I've set my image to print and cut, and so I have the printout here from my printer, and I want to bring it closer to show you exactly what it does. If you look at the edges of the butterfly, can you see how the image is a little blurred or extended? And that's done so when it cuts into, if it misses the image a little bit, you're not going to get a white edge. So we're going to load this into the maker. And I've set my computer up so that you can see here that it's on a medium cardstock, and that's what I printed it out to. And now it's ready to cut, so I'm going to cut it. Now that it's cutting around the image of the butterfly, and here's the shaking as I eject it there, and then I'll show you that if I lift this up, that what it's done is it has cut out our shape. And if we look really close at the edge, you'll see that there are no white shapes showing. Because the original cut, you can see it's cut into that blurry edge to help cut the shape out. And it really is just that simple.